हेलो वेलकम एवरीवन टू दिस केमिस्ट्री चैनल। आई एम जमीर शेख, फैकल्टी ऑफ केमिस्ट्री फ्रॉम श्री शिवाजी कॉलेज ऑफ आर्ट्स कॉमर्स एंड साइंस अकोला। सो टुडे वी विल सी द इम्पॉर्टेंट नेम रिएक्शन, दैट इज द बेलिस हिलमन रिएक्शन। सो द रिएक्शन इज नेम्ड एज व्हाट? बेलिस हिलमन रिएक्शन, वन ऑफ द ग्रेट एप्लीकेबिलिटी इन ऑर्गेनिक सिंथेसिस। दिस रिएक्शंस हैव लॉट्स ऑफ एप्लीकेशंस, पर्टिकुलरली इन द बायोमेडिकल्स। मेनी एप्लीकेशंस आर गिवन। सो द प्रोडक्ट विच इज प्रोड्यूस्ड ओके इन दिस रिएक्शंस हैव लॉट्स ऑफ एप्लीकेशंस। सो दिस रिएक्शन इज वेरी वन ऑफ द स्पेशल टाइप ऑफ रिएक्शंस। सो टुडे वी विल सी द प्रिंसिपल reaction scheme, the mechanism, applications and some examples of what Bayliss-Hillman reaction. So first of all, introductory part of this Bayliss-Hillman reactions. Bayliss-Hillman reaction is an example of carbon-carbon bond formation reaction, just like the coupling reaction. So the reaction is takes place between an alpha position of what? Activated alkene. Alpha position of what? Activated alkene and what? Carbon electrophile as an aldehyde or ketone, right? So there are only two reactant are required for this reaction. One is your activated alkene. You know that activated alkene is nothing but the what? Your olefin should be attached with electron withdrawing substrate, right? You can use any conjugated substrate, okay? So that olefin should be attached with the what? Your electron withdrawing substrates now, okay? And along with that, your second partner, either you can use aldehyde or either you can use what? The ketone. So here this aldehydes and ketones are act as what? Electrophile, and there is a bond formation between alpha position of what? Your activated olefin along with the what? The your carbon of your carbonyl group, okay, from aldehyde or ketone. Then here what is the role of what reagent now? Which reagents are used in this reaction? So this reaction is employing with the help of what? Catalyst. And the catalyst in this reaction is an what? Tertiary amine. So it is a nucleophilic catalyst. Either you can along with the phosphine also, somewhere we can use the tertiary amine along with the phosphine, okay? And that reaction provides a functionalized product which have lots of applications. This reaction is named after Kenichi Morita, Bayliss and the Hillman, okay? And that's why this reaction is also be named as Morita Bayliss Hillman reaction. Now we will see the reaction scheme of Bayliss Hillman reaction. So first of all, look here. So first reactant is a conjugated olefin molecule, that is activated alkene. Second is your aldehyde or ketone, okay? And in a presence of a DAPCO as a catalyst, okay, this is, and you have seen that DAPCO is a bicyclic amine, diamine, okay? And in a presence of a tertiary amines, NR3 or PPR3. So finally you get the product now. Here if you see that in a product, your alkene is retained, your what? Your activated alkene is retained, but the reduction is takes place of your carbonyl compound, and there is a bond formation between alpha position of what? Activated olefin with your carbonyl carbon as an aldehyde or ketone. Again if you see that in this reaction here, activated alkene, your X may be OR NH2 or OR NH2 or NR2. A Y is nothing but the what? Oxygen, either NTS or either what? The NCO2R. And R1, R2, we can refer for that R1 and R2 are nothing but the what? Alkyl group, aryl group or simple hydrogen, okay? So they have lots of, particularly we have selectivity also, we can use anything, okay? I just picked what are the main requirements particularly for that. This is the reaction scheme. Here puts the simple reactions, that's the base Bayliss-Hillman reaction. So here we are given, first of all, this aldehyde reacts with conjugated olefin molecule, and in presence of a DAPCO there is a formation of the product now. Okay, so if we see that the conjugated part of that alkene is retained, okay, a reduction of carbonyl group is takes place along with the formation of carbon-carbon bond. This is the reactions. Now we'll see the first of all the mechanism of these reactions, and before that we must require the demanding substrate. What are the type of substrates are required? At the left side of the slide we see that these are the activated alkene, and I already told that activated alkenes are nothing but they are what, the conjugated olefins molecule, like conjugated molecules. We have seen that different varieties of molecules we can choose and just write that alpha position, alpha alpha alpha, all where the molecules now. Okay, so at all over the molecules you can put the alpha position because we have to require that alpha position now. Okay, and in right side of the slide now here they are using electrophiles. They are nothing but the what, your aldehydes or ketone. Okay, simply we can just combine two substrate along with your catalyst. Finally you get the functionalized atom or functionalized product. The role of reagent now, most importantly, because this reaction is catalyzed by that reagent, that's why you must know about the reagent. Here in Bailey-Zeilman reactions we are using the DAPCO. What is DAPCO now? At the right side of the slide we are mentioned the structure of our DAPCO and it's a utility. It's a utility. Okay, so what is DAPCO now? A DAPCO is 1,4-diazabicyclo-222-octane. It is IUPAC name because it is a bicyclic molecule. Okay, as we seen in the structure, DAPCO is an organic compound with the formula N2C2H4 thrice. It's a highly nucleophilic because it's tertiary amine, also act as a base and which is used in the catalyst in the polymerization as well as in the many organic synthetic reactions. What are the features of our DAPCO? It acts as a Lewis base, additive reagents. It is a component of ionic liquid, also act as a nucleophile reagent, act as a catalyst and act as also the substrate. These are the versatile applications of what, the DAPCO. This is the mechanism of the Bailey-Zeilman reaction. In this mechanism we'll see that the first step is what, the conjugate addition. We have already conjugate molecule is given, okay, as an activated alkene. That activated alkene is reacted with the DAPCO. What is DAPCO? The structure is of the DAPCO is present like here. The lone pair of the nitrogens are reacted at the 1,4 position of your activated alkene. There is a formation of what, the adductor first. Bond will be open to conjugated oxygen. Finally, that when the oxygen pair, the electron pair will be restored, okay, that alpha position of that activated molecules are directly reacted with the what, the your carbonyl carbon of your aldehyde or either what, the ketone. Okay, then the bond will be open to what, your oxygen finally. So you get this structure, third structure. Finally the proton transfer will gives that carbonyl oxygen becomes converts to what, the hydroxy group, and later on the lone pair from that conjugated oxygen will be restored, and then your tertiary amines, that is a DAPCO, basically it is a quaternary now, okay, and it is a good leaving group. So in fourth structure we have seen that this quaternary amine will be free as a simple DAPCO and finally will leads to what, your functionalized product. So this is a very simple mechanism. So there are only three steps are there. First step is conjugate addition between DAPCO and your activated alkene. Second step is what, your adductor combined with your carbonyl compound which is act as an electrophile here. So that's why we are always put the in electrophilic position now, second molecule, okay, we require aldehyde and ketone, not the esters and etc, because aldehydes are and ketones are more electrophilic than other. So finally the proton transfer is takes place and elimination of what, the quaternary amines, and you get the product now, okay, like this. So here the another same mechanism is given now, okay, instead of what, they are just changing the some substrate. Here mechanism is 1,4 addition followed by the addition to carbonyl carbon, alpha position bond is takes place, CC bond is takes place, proton transfer, finally the elimination of quaternary salt, and that will be the product. Okay, you must draw the mechanism of these reactions very systematic and very one of the beautiful example of the CC bond formation. Generally we know that either conjugate addition it takes place, either 1,2 addition it takes place, but here we are joined the bond from with the what, the alpha position of what, olefin with the your carbonyl carbon. there are lots of applications. What the use of your product now? The product particularly, that is here mentioned the green. So here G is a donating or several groups you can use. Okay, here X is a your hydroxy group, or maybe the O or the NTS, and EAG is in what, your electron activator groups. Okay, there are lots of application: anti-malaria, antifungal, herbicides, antibacterial, anti-cancer, etc., etc. There all are the we have several research papers, gone through the several research paper, you find that this Bayley Siddeman reactions have lot of applications in the this field. In the second application, again I just take this slide from sciencedirect.com. so here this compound which is produced in the Bayley Siddeman reactions have lots of application, as in oxygen compound, nitrogen, sulfur, selenium, miscellaneous compound, the mechanistic aspect, drug candidates, the biological activity and structural activity relationship. There are lots of applications in the this field of Bayley Siddeman reaction. Here lastly I mentioned some examples. First of all, you can use the aldehyde or ketone as an act as electrophile, and secondly we have a conjugated substrate. Okay, and most importantly we have a DAPCO. If there is no DAPCO, there will be no reaction will be takes place, and finally you get the product. In second reactions we have a bifunctional reactant at aldehyde and ester. So always remember that aldehydes and ketones are more electrophilic, so always use the aldehydes. Okay, and finally you see that 34% product is obtained. Okay, so and the reaction is always proceed with what, the aldehyde, not with the what, your ester and all that. Okay, so in some cases instead of a DAPCO, if PPS3 is used now, that reaction is called what, the Morita reaction. Okay, and in generally if DAPCO as well as PPS3 is given, then reaction is called what, the Morita Bayley Hellman reaction. So thank you very much for watching this video. So if you like the content, or if you satisfied with this content, please like, share and subscribe our channel, and we will upload the third name reactions soon. Thank you.